Hi, it's Rich, the Louisiana Hobby Guy, and today we're going to talk about setting up an odd shape so that we can make a design on it to burn in lightburn. So I was on a discussion group and I got a question about how to frame out an odd shape and how to put a design inside of it. The easy answer to this is to take a photograph of it. Now, if you have a laser that has a camera, a built-in camera, you know how easy this is to do. You can take a photo and you can design your burn from there. But if you don't have a camera in an enclosure, then all you have to do is take a good photo of it from above in natural lighting, try and get it as square as you can in the camera frame, and then go ahead and import that, we're gonna do that now, into your work plane. So now this is a picture of a piece of wood, and you know, it's just any piece of wood, just for the demonstration. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click on that and make sure it's selected with the handles all the way around. Then I'm going to right click on it and I'm going to come down here to trace image. And I'm just going to say okay, because lightburn's pretty good at tracing. Then I'm going to drag that trace off of the original photograph and delete the original. Now with this unselected, we're going to come over here to the left side toolbar and grab the draw lines tool, the pencil. So we'll click on that. We'll come over here and zoom in a bit and start right here in the corner, and I just made a click. So now you'll see that it snaps to whatever it finds. So it snaps right there, I'm gonna click right there. And this is the edge right here, so we're gonna click right there. We're gonna move down here, click. Gonna move down here, click. Move down here and click. Move over to right here and click. And then there and click, and then here and click, and we're just going to keep clicking all the way around the outside of the image. So now when we get to right about here, we know that this is a straight line all the way to the top, and we know that this is a straight line all the way to the end. Now when I get to the end, my last click is going to close the shape, and I'll show you what I mean. So if I go over here, click, 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 I still have the line. You have to close the shape by letting it snap to the end and doing that. Okay, let's get rid of this one. And now if we come back over here with our selector tool selected up in the top left, we're going to select that line and we're going to take and drag it off of the original photograph. We're going to drag over the entire original photograph and delete it. And now we can bring our image back in. Now pay attention to these numbers up here. I've got this in inches and these are my guides right here. So I want to, I'm going to push down on my mouse wheel and drag the screen up all the way up until I see this 1 and 0. Now, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to drag this guy down, put it right up against the side here, bring it all the way down to the bottom, and it's slightly off. I wasn't square on my picture, so I'm going to make it as square as I possibly can, like that, by grabbing that outer handle. Okay, and we can get a little bit closer so that we're exact, and then come just a little bit further down. I'm holding the control key and I'm using my down arrow to get a very slow movement. So now I'm aligned here, I'm aligned here. Now I take the measurement from my wood in the workshop from here to here, and I found that that was 6 inches. I'm gonna grab this corner handle here, and you see my six inch mark right here, 6 inches. I'm going to pull this out to exactly 6 inches. What we have is a shape that's ready to design on. So now I can put my design all throughout here and know that it's gonna burn perfectly on the wood. For example, if I were to take some text and select it, bring it over here, and then grab this little blue dot right here and curve it, and curve curve it again. I can get it right into the curve of that wood and set it up so that it burns right on the edge of the wood. Put the rest of my graphics in here. Now, getting it ready to put on your laser bed, you would take and put the wood down on the bed, and you would frame it, and you'd only be concerned with this area right here. So from here to here and here to here is where you're going to line it up for framing on the square edges. I hope this video helped you. Thank you for watching.